Hello and welcome to another Flutter Mentor video tutorial. This time we're going to take it all the way back to something as basic as what is the difference between a child and children. This video comes about after a request from one of my subscribers. As you can see, the UI has never been more simple and neither has the code, and we'll get right back to this. But first allow me to explain with some visuals. So this is a matter of quantity. Think of just one widget and also a list of widgets. In this case, it's a list of three widgets. Now, there's a child and there are children. Child is singular and children is plural. A child only takes one widget. That's it. You cannot add any more widgets as a direct child of a widget. Now, children, on the other hand, means that it expects multiple widgets. And what am I talking about? It expects. Well, we're talking about widgets. For example, the container widget expects a child. A single child, and not any more, just one direct child. That's it. One widget, one child, period. Now the column widget expects a list of children, which means that you can add as many children as you need. In this case, we just added three, but in theory, there's no limit. Obviously, there are technological limits, but you're not going to run into that limit. Now, these are just example widgets. For example, the row, much like the column, can also take a list of children. And the padding widget, much like the container widget, expects a single child. But the column can also take only one child, because it's still a list, but it's a list of one element only. So basically, a child is a single child, and children is a list of children, okay? It's basically a bunch of childs. That word doesn't exist in English, but I'll use it to explain this. Children is basically a bunch of child as a list. But back to Android Studio, and we pretty much only have a scaffold widget. Let's get rid of the app bar property, and we have a background color defined, which is this one. Now, if you want to add content, you need to use the body property. And I don't know if you noticed that, but as I typed it, it says right here, widget. What does that mean? It means it expects a widget. But you can also click Control Q and you get a bunch of information about the property or the widget depending on what you are checking. And as you can see, it says type widget. That means that only a widget can be used on this property of the scaffold widget. So let's add a container. Let's give it a height and a width. If I save this, nothing will happen. So let's give it a color. Now, if I save this, it's red. Now let's give it a child. But in case you didn't know it took a child, you can do Control Q again. And then you just gotta look for it. This here is the class that the widget pertains to, and this is the widget's name, and here are the properties of said widget. So you can always check here to see if it's a child or children. In this case, it's a child, so it says it expects a type widget, which we will do right now. Let's give it just a regular piece of text, say box one, save it, and there it is. But that's it. We can't do anything else right now because the body property is the only option that we have right now to design content into the UI. So widgets with a child are very limited. So let's go ahead and put a column here, which we already know takes a list of children, but we can always check here. And here it is, list of widgets as children. This is what it takes, this is the property name, and this is what it expects, a list of widgets. So all you gotta do is come here, type C. In fact, if you type C, it'll tell you if it expects children or a child, but we wanted children, so here we are. Now here, we can just place a bunch of widgets as if it were a list, like so. And now within each of the widgets, we can provide a child, and let's just do the same for all. Now if I save this, this is the column right here. But let's make it even more obvious. If I save, it will become longer, but let's give it a color so you can really see what's going on. And here it is, a list of children. The containers are the children. And if you want it, you can even make the column a child of a container. Let's give this a color as well, and let's see what happens. That might look weird to you, but that's because columns take up the entire vertical space. So let's give dimensions to our container. And now you can probably understand it even better. Now we have a container, which is the yellow, and the child of that container is the column, which is all of this right here. And the column has three children, which are box one, box two, and box three right here. And you can even chain another widget like center to make it all centered. And as you can see, the container is a child of the center, and then the column is a child of the container. And we can even go an extra step and make center the parent of column. And if we do min axis size, min, it will all be centered. And we can even take it an extra step, and the container's child is the text, but we can make the container's child a center widget, which then has the text as a child. If we do this for all of them, everything is centered. And to make sure you understand, Here is a visual representation of what we've just done, widget-wise. The first widget on the body property is the center widget, which takes a container as a child, which takes a center as a child, which in turn takes a column as a child. Now, the column is the only widget here that can take children, so it takes three children, three containers to be more precise. And each of these containers separately takes a center widget as a child. And each of those center widgets each has a text as a child as well. So my advice is try to create a bunch of widgets with children and some with just a child, and then you try to design what I just did, which is basically a widget map representing your widget structure. If we come back here, you will see that it's completely correct. Center, container, center, column, three containers. Each container has a center widget, which then has a child text widget. I think that's as far as we can go to explain this concept, even if you're a beginner. So I hope you were able to understand all of this. If you didn't, just rewatch the video and you can be sure that you will understand it perfectly. And when you do understand, please don't forget to leave me a like and subscribe so I can keep doing this, helping people like you learn how to program for free. That's my goal here. So without anything else to add, this is Flutter Mentor, and out.